Hi, I'm Clare Clingain. I am an A3SR alumni. That's the Applied Statistics Program at NYU Steinhardt. And today you're going to be following me around for a day in my life. So it's just at 6. That's why I look like this. And I'm just getting my work laptop set up and making some breakfast for the day. I typically start work at 7, or just after 7. It's early days, but it's good stuff. I've been working as a research coordinator at the International Rescue Committee for just over a year, since June 2019. I graduated from the Applied Stats program in May 2019. The concentrations came around just in my second year, and it was in computational methods. So yeah, just waiting for the pan to heat up. Got my tea brewing. You know, I need a strong cup of Irish tea to start the day, even though this is technically decaf. So I support the economic research portfolio at our IRC. That means I'm involved in everything from research design to dissemination and everything that falls in between that, like data analysis. I use so many of the skills I picked up in the program, like survey design. Thank you, Daphna. It's something I use with every survey that I make at IRC. And then also like causal inference, just computational skills and how you get creative trying to do what you need to do in R, thanks to Mark. And then your basics, like Sharon's classes on regression, those are priceless. So just got back from my morning walk. It's my official morning commute now. It's weird not properly commuting. Like I'm a native New Yorker. I commuted to NYU for undergrad. I commuted there for grad school. I was there for applied psychology for undergrad and got really into research through working in a lab, and then stuck around for grad school for applied stats, which was one of the best decisions I ever made. So it's weird not moving out of my home, but it's all good. I'm just checking emails, have a few power analyses I gotta run this morning, which, you know, my favorite thing to do at 7:15 in the morning. But I gotta get everything done before a few meetings with about dissemination of findings and everything. So I'll see you back. So finally off of calls for the morning. It's just about 11 o'clock. But it was a good break from, you know, look at this beautiful power curve. Can't go wrong. I was just working on some survey contextualization. We're trying to do some research in 3 different countries, and so you have to make adjustments so it's the questions are relevant. And it's one of my favorite things, you know, and I think it's so important for stats to think through and input into what are we measuring, why are we measuring this, like who is it relevant for. And it feeds a bit into this like do no harm principle we have, like as a sector, as a whole, entering into humanitarian settings. Is this measuring this, you know, what we should be doing? Are we going to do harm by doing this? It's always a lot to think about. So I'm just taking a quick break. I need to refer to some books. I'm stuck on a problem. And I find it useful to just seek out other help. This book is actually by Jennifer, and it makes me think of how fortunate I was to have 4 amazing female statisticians as role models and resources in the program. There's Jennifer, Daphna, Ying, and Sharon. It's something I miss now. Like a lot of the stats guys I interact with, they're guys, right? They're, especially when you get into like really heavy theoretical computational math parts, you don't see a lot of women. And even in some applied sectors, like depending on, you know, I work on economic research, so you could imagine there's a lot of men. So it was priceless having them as role models. I've been working on some write-up of findings and just summarizing some of our pilot work. And, you know, that was one of the great things with the classes, is being forced to write up things in like technical papers or research paper format. And also thinking through like who's your audience when you're writing results or talking about a method. It's a priceless skill to get to work on, and something I found so useful in my work now. I'm also just prepping for tomorrow, checking through my calendar, which is just packed full.
and also getting messages as I try to finish work. But now I'll go on a walk and just clear my head for the day's work and get ready for tomorrow.
Got a perfect view of the Bayonne Bridge. Such a great view from where I live. Just refreshing and clearing my mind, but I'm still getting messages. But some of them are from my cohort mates from the program, and it's just great to keep in touch and use them as a resource. So back from my walk, it's just about 5. Thanks for following me around a day in my life working from home at the IRC.